Smart home garage door opener for under 50 bucks? Seriously? Today, I'll show you how. Every single day, I'm gonna make something great. That's my way. Every single day. I have an old Belkin Wemo smart switch, works over Wi-Fi. I have an old power supply cable from some old walkie-talkies I had, so it didn't cost me anything. I bought this relay on Amazon for probably $3, and this wire I already had. So let's dive into how I got this all set up. So now I'll just give you a basic rundown of hooking up the relay. The main things you want to look for when you get a relay is 85 and 86 and 30 to 87. Pretty much every relay has those same four main posts, and they're all usually labeled the same. 85 and 86 or the coil, which is where your power from your power supply gets hooked to that, and it does not matter which wires you hook to either terminal. It does not matter because you're just closing off the circuit. And on the bottom of the relay, normally you can see where it says right there, it says 86, 85 over here. So across these two terminals goes your power. You just make sure you look at the bottom that you see those markings on there. That's the most important on the relay portion. So once you plug those in, get that hooked up, and then the only other two are your 30 to 87, which are going to be the wires that actually control your garage door opener. And again, those don't matter either. You can hook those up in any direction. And same with when you're hooking it up to the garage door opener, it does not matter what wire goes to what. So if you're not familiar with wiring anything, it's very, very simple. You cannot screw it up. So when you're hooking these up with the red leads from the relay down to here, like I was saying before, it does not matter what red lead goes to what wire. So there's no wrong way of doing this, which just kind of makes it easier to hook it up. So once you get these all hooked up, I just got a couple wing nuts that you just kind of screw on here. And essentially that's it. All right guys, here's everything plugged in. I got my power, got my relay mounted to the top. Got it spliced into where the contacts would be for the actual opener down there. So you tap it into that same circuit. So now that you got everything all hooked up, just open the Wemo app, and we label it all as garage. You click it to turn it on. And then click it again to turn it off. And then click it again, turn it on. It'll start closing again, and then just shut it back off. All right, guys, I hope that video was helpful. The only downfall is you won't get a notification if the garage door opens or closes, but it's more of just a DIY smart garage door opener with some stuff that's laying around the house. The old Wemo switch I had, I originally bought it for like 35 bucks. The relay and some wiring and just kind of in the power supply from some old electronics, hook it all together, and you got yourself a smart garage door opener. So I know there's some better stuff out there, but hopefully this helps you out. And just hit the like button, subscribe, hit the reminder bell, and I'll catch you guys next time. Peace.